Just like something with the parts. Yeah, a lot of parts, a lot of different things. A car. Thank you.
Take this online quiz, like, what video game character are you? But it's gotten very out of hand.
It's really out of hand. Yeah, like, I personally thought it was pretty funny when Lucas took so well to his role as a golf.
I used to be an adventurer like you, but I took
an arrow
to the
knee. There you go.
He's really into it.
Yep.
Let me guess. Someone stole your sweet one.
I mean, people have been getting closer, though.
That's true. Like, the old hero and new hero. Meg has been having so much fun training Rachel.
Oh, yeah, there they are.
Oh, there they go.
You won't be able to overcome your college applications that easily, kid. I'm already on the second year of my campaign. I've already learned a super cool intimidating fight stance.
Oh, that's great, but it alone won't be enough to save you from the Calvin dungeon.
I mean, the results did get oddly specific, though.
Yeah, no, like, it made sense to me that Julian got Traveling Merchant, but then Zoe got thief that only steals from a traveling merchant named Julian. That was a little weird.
Guard. She stole my limited edition of Iron Man.
I'm
do something.
Borrowing it so I can get to know my bestie better.
You there!
Ha, you're gonna get an hour.
You violated the law. What say you in your defense? Gah!
You know, but Julian, he has some tough competition for my cash.
Sophie drives a hard bargain.
That is true.
Oh. Leggings, get your leggings here. I got pink, gray, purple, any color of the rainbow. You'll never be lost again.
That's really cool. I think I have enough leggings, though.
Do you have 87 pairs?
Oh, no.
I had 87 pairs of leggings once.
Faith has become unbearable since she got the old mentor.
But I have lost them all long ago, scattered across the nation of Tamriel. Perhaps I need a young, strapping, attractive apprentice to inherit my blade of woe.
Oh yeah, equipment upgrade!
Okay, they're all kind of a lot, but like no one scares me as much as Lily, the villain.
What's here? Yeah.
You can run, but you can't hide. It's speedy running legs to catch you every time.
Vanquish her, young Padawan!
I was a Padawan once.
Peter lost my sword!
Zoe!
That was me. Oh. I still print leggings or half off.
I can save for whatever the half is telling you.
Oh. What an oblivion is that?
I was in oblivion once!
You can't take my leggings! I can't!
You can't run from your destiny, Laurel. What's our destiny, Lily?
To have
an improv show!
Reintroduce the team. So I am one of the student co-captains, Laurel.
I am the other student co-captain, Daisy.
I'm Meg.
I'm Rachel.
I'm Lily.
I'm Sophie.
I'm Julian.
I'm Zoe.
I'm Sadie.
Yeah. If you guys haven't been to an improv show before, all of this is comedy that we make up on the spot. That last thing you saw was the only thing that's going to be scripted all night.
Mm-hmm. And the other very important thing with improv is it relies on the audience. So let's practice a little bit. Can you guys tell me all your name?
That was pretty good. Let's try something a little bit harder. What is your favorite fruit?
All right, and lastly, what are your guys' favorite colors?
Okay, awesome. It seems like you all are ready for some improv, and I know we're ready for improv. So, for our first game, I am going to turn it over to Meg for News Center.
We are interrupting your nightly programming of America's Next Top Model to deliver to you this breaking news. Now, could I please have some very ordinary thing that you did today?
Walk the dog. Also.
You walk the dog? What's your name?
Paul.
Paul walks the dog. Everyone, this is absolutely shocking. And to get a closer look at it, we have his next door neighbor, Prim.
Yeah, so I was just looking out my window and oh my gosh, Paul with that giant black dog.
I know, right?
I was just stunned. I mean, I don't let my kids leave the house when that dog is out.
No, it's so crazy. It's so dangerous, man.
Seriously, like, he needs to get a bigger leash or something.
You gotta keep that dog away, man.
Definitely.
So, to learn more about this reportedly big black dog, I am calling in our resident dog specialist to give us more details.
Yeah, so, basically, when it comes to dogs, the bigger they are, the scarier they are. So, how it's gonna work is, what we got here is what we got. We got a big dog. And so, when you look at that, a big dog, it's scary. And yeah, I'm not gonna lie to you, it's really scary for the kids and the neighbors, and it's bad.
Do you think they should call animal control on this dog?
Yeah, but I wouldn't want to be, that's scary, so.
Now, we were told that he kept his dog on a leash, as per the law, but I need to get a proper product review of this leash to be able to find out if he really had the proper equipment.
You see, the leeches are exactly 3/4 of an inch. So when you combine it with this bacteria, you see a picture of him walking the dog here, you can tell that it would take approximately 25 billion tons to keep that dog with strange.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
It's a big dog. It's scary.
It's a big dog.
It's a big scary dog.
Yeah, no, it's gigantic and scary, and I personally, not for me.
I would agree.
In the fabric, it just helps restrain the dog.
Yeah, what's with the fabric on the leash? It doesn't even work!
To close it out, we have a final statement from Paul, the dog walker himself. Paul, please tell us about your morning.
Well, today I was walking the dog, and per usual, it was every morning, except for Sundays because I go to church. Afterwards, I was casually walking along and I saw on the news, they were reporting me walking my dog. I mean, look at it. It's not that scary.
Come on.
I felt a disturbing sense of lack of privacy. People reporting on my dog.
You're fine.
She likes you.
The dog is really scary.
It's not that scary.
She likes you too.
System.
Right.
I just think that maybe we shouldn't put the children's books on the highest shelves. Because, like, little kids, they jump to get them all the time.
You know,
they've been falling.
That's a great point. But, you know, I feel like getting them up on those ladders, that gives them a little bit of exercise. That just, you know, it provides a little extra challenge. You know, maybe you're right.
Yeah. So, oh, I have this plan, right? Total library reorganization. I have this plan. It's for me to become the manager and for you to, you know, take a step back a little bit. And my plan is that we put all the kids in zip line harnesses so that when they need the books, they can just zip on up there.
Might be a little expensive.
Did you give me okay? I have a zip line. Wait. Like 2 seconds, okay? You said yes, right?
Yes.
Yeah!
Well, kind of a little bit. I may have said yes a few minutes ago, but I really think we need to rethink all this.
I'm hearing a go ahead.
Yeah, I'm thinking yes.
I have been rethinking.
This might be a little bit of an OSHA violation. This might be a little dangerous for the kids, I might say.
So the librarians go on the zip line.
What?
Mini job upgrade. Yeah!
Well, you two have a very interesting way of communication.
Just told me about her morning.
Oh, of course. I do like the idea of us librarians, you know, getting up there on those zip lines. I feel like it could be a nice little bonding activity for us.
We said librarians, not managers. See, we weren't including you in this plan.
No, that's okay. It's all right.
It's just like the summer job that I really wanted was to be at a zip line park, and then the summer job that I really wanted was to make ice cream. But, you know, dude,
We know that you're a little scared of heights. And it's just, we wouldn't like kids falling down and adults falling down. What is enough?
All right, then. That seems like a pretty good, that's a really solid plan.
Mm-hmm.
I guess we could just stick with you two, you know, going up there on the zip lines.
We had an idea for you, though.
Oh, what is that?
So, okay, hear me out, okay? So we're up on the zip line.
Right.
Obviously, we're going to hit some shelves, so you get to pick up all the books we dropped.
Oh.
So today we are going to be playing a game called Foursquare, and it's where four people will be doing four different scenes, and the two people in the back will be calling clockwise or clockwise reverse. So, yeah, can I please have an occupation?
Firefighter.
Can we have a task to accomplish? The people in the back will not have that one.
Building a jet ski.
Building a jet ski.
Building a jet ski. Building a jet ski. Building a jet ski. Building a
jet ski.
Building a jet ski.
Finding a dog is what I heard.
Could we please have an adventure we are going on? I heard climbing a mountain.
And can I have a place we are at? We are at Atlantis.
To review, firefighters.
We are finding a dog.
We are climbing a mountain.
And we are in Atlantis. Lost City ain't so lost anymore.
Oh, I know. Right?
Oh my gosh. So it wasn't that hard. It's underwater. I say it's underwater.
No,
it's all we have to do is go down here.
Exactly.
It's not that hard. It's just like, so why don't we check it out? See what's in here.
Yeah.
Okay, so we got.
Maybe gold.
Well, I hope so.
Yeah.
Let's just check it out. Let's go in there.
Clockwise once.
Yeah. All right, Bucko. So, your first day on the job? Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. It's just, fire. Not really.
Not too much of a fire guy, no problem.
Yeah.
We'll get you used to that real quick, all right? We got about 70 calls a day, so I'm sure you'll have tons of stuff to do, bud.
Right. But you see, the thing is, fire is just bad, right?
That's fair, yeah.
It hurts. Mm-hmm. So what if I just, answer the phone calls, right?
You could do that, I suppose. But, I feel personally that it's a lot better to just get in there, get that experience, and get out.
Okay. That's fair.
Yeah.
Counterclockwise three times.
Okay, so we checked the fridge.
We checked the oven.
Yeah. The trash can.
Did we check?
I think we got that.
Mm-hmm.
I just, Mom's gonna be so mad. If she finds out that Sparky got lost.
Again? I mean, this happened twice already.
It's happened twice in the same day already. I just don't know what Mom's gonna do when she finds out.
Yeah. Out there, the window. Someone's walking Sparky.
Oh! Yeah, no, that is our big,
that's
black,
Sparky.
Scary dog.
I don't remember giving that to an animal shelter.
I don't either.
Clockwise once. Hey, you got all your stuff?
I have all my gear.
Okay. Okay, you have a bag of granola.
I do have a bag of granola. Mm-hmm.
That's a...
You thought you had all of ours, and you brought all the equipment because I've never done this before.
Well, I was kind of assuming you'd bring like shoes and like pants. I was hoping, but so you forgot that it happens.
I'm sorry.
It happens. I get it.
Well, it's a warm day. I thought I could go with shorts.
So, I mean, I guess you can just take. Maybe if you want to wear the bags of granola, maybe on your feet instead of the shoes that you didn't bring. So.
Oh, well, I could, but I could also use them as knee pads. But your idea is better, and I will use them as shoes.
Okay, perfect. Let me just...
Once. Dude, chopsticks?
No!
Oh my gosh.
That's so exciting. Yeah, that's like the coolest thing ever.
Right.
I think we can... Should we go back up now?
Yeah, I mean, we could. Searching. I heard. You know what I heard?
What'd you hear?
Hair.
And
millions.
Millions of dollars of hair.
Yes.
Okay, I'm not totally. Is your oxygen tank like a little low?
Okay.
So, I'm a little confused.
There's this myth if we find the hair.
Yeah.
Money.
Like, okay, I was thinking Rapunzel,
money.
I'm starting to get what you're saying. I haven't heard this before. I'm learning all the things.
Clockwise twice. Okay, so you wouldn't give us a dog.
I know. Well, we tried bribery.
We tried that.
We tried threatening.
Yup.
None of it worked.
We even tried stealing him back.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't quite work. He seemed a lot happier with the other dude.
I even rattled his favorite bag of treats.
Exactly.
Sparky still didn't come back.
Sparky's treats that have been the same bag of treats we've used since like 2016.
Exactly. And he still didn't recognize them?
Exactly.
Oh.
We gotta find another way to get him back.
Yeah. You know, I just remembered he's deaf, so that must be why it didn't
work. That must be why it worked.
Alright, so. First day.
Yeah.
You got through about 70 fires already. We'll work on that.
Yeah.
We'll work on that.
So, I was thinking about a raise, right? You know, I did 75 fires. I know it's my first day, but...
returning through a nice little conversation. So, can I have some items you would not normally return? Like, can I actually have it from just like the front corner?
Ashes? Potatoes.
Okay, I would take potatoes and doggy sweater. Okay, now we're gonna call him back in. So, can on the count of three, can I have "Hey, you improvers"? Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Hey, you improvers!
Okay.
Yep.
It's broken.
There's really a lot of them here.
Yeah, I'm a collector.
Oh, that's nice.
Since I was a kid.
Since you were a kid, did you like grow them with your dad as a child?
Or I stole them.
Oh, well, that's cool too, I guess. So you said it was broken.
Yeah.
What'd you try to do with them?
Okay, so I ran into my neighbor's garden as I normally do, right? And I'm scurrying along the bushes. I grab it. I pick it up. I run away. And then, like,
you're a fast digger, I guess.
Oh, I'm so fast. You wouldn't believe it. But anyway, I take it home and I use it as my normal refreshments. You know? So I just, really good. It's really good. And then I put it in the sink, you know, maybe dry it off a little bit, wait for it to fully ripen.
I'm still a little.
I'm not finished.
Okay.
So then I take all of it and I put it as a pillow filling, right? Except this time.
This is after you drank it.
Yes. So you gotta get rid of all the soft innards of it.
Oh.
I really try to live like our grandfather's.
So you
plus.
you put it in a blender and
no.
then like
it's just you just. Yep.
Cool. That's gotta be one like strong, you know, you got going on there.
Like I said, since I was a kid.
that's pretty great, okay. So then the pillow filler, is that like peelings?
Well, I tried that at first.
Okay.
Just kind of like, you know.
Yeah.
Like, and they're just so flat. So I actually took the skins off. I cooked
okay.
it.
Oh.
Right, I cooked
yeah.
it and it
yeah.
got all mushy.
Yeah, no, that does happen.
All right, so then I tried it, but I was like, this is too soft.
Mm.
Typically
when people mash it, they put in like butter, salt, like a little bit to, you know.
I haven't tried that before.
That's usually for eating it though, so I don't know if it would work as a pillow filling.
Yeah, I get that. It's just like, you know, I really love all things potatoes.
Yeah, no, that's fair, and these clearly not good for that. So
yeah,
I'm gonna give you some store credit.
Oh, awesome!
Just yep.
All right,
there you go.
Thank you.
Yep.
Hello.
Hey.
I just brought a suitcase. I just want.
Whoa.
Carry all that.
There you go.
Yeah. I just wanted to return it. It wasn't. Doing what I wanted it to, so.
It didn't, you know, look the way you wanted it to.
You know, I really just, I don't like colors like that. It's too much for me. It's not my
style. Did it not match, like, the fur?
Exactly, yeah, it just kind of clashed all together.
No, that makes sense.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. For me, like, I always get, like, pink and orange ones, like, to match, like, white, you know?
Right, yeah.
But
colors mixing.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Orange and pink, and
No, this is not great. So what'd you do when you buy these? How'd you like figure out that it didn't quite work?
Yeah, I just kind of messed with it a little bit. I just saw it and I was like, I collect these a lot, so I like to use them. But
did you like hold it up next to your pet and like see?
You know, he wasn't with me.
Oh,
so I was just like, oh, that would look cute. And then I brought it home. It didn't match. You know, the color. He's kind of a mix of colors.
Oh,
brown,
yeah.
White, or like, it didn't really work because I got pink. It's like, it's a very vibrant. It's a very
that's
bright
fair.
Neon
that's
pink,
fair.
Right?
It's a
so,
shame though because I've heard this brand is actually like really warm for
yeah.
them.
Yeah, it is really warm. I like fashion, so I just really wanted to. We need to match up, right?
Oh,
I'm
oh fair,
walks,
fair.
We need to look fashionable.
You guys,
yeah. Mm-hmm. I love taking him on walks, and I live in New York, so it's got to be on.
Oh, right. Yeah, New York fashion is everything.
Everyone just, all my friends are fashionistas, so if I put up to a party with my dog in a bright pink, you know, clothes, it just...
yeah, bright pink clothes that
yeah,
keep your dog warm.
Yeah.
I don't know what that would, yeah.
I just...
That would really suck.
Yeah, it would suck at all. I would
yeah, yeah, yeah. So you're interested in different
yeah.
colors.
Definitely.
You
yeah.
tried it on him, right? And you were like, oh,
yeah,
now he's all
yeah.
cozy, comfy in the little knit
so
clothing.
I love the knit stuff, especially. But in class, I just have this niche harness on, and it didn't
oh,
really work. It just
yeah,
it was
yeah.
too bulky. So
yeah.
Yeah.
No, that's totally fair.
Knit dog sweater. I just love
I would recommend our Allendale location. They actually let you take your dog right in.
Yes.
So then you can try it on him and
nice.
Make sure and just
yeah.
show them that. They'll let you
so
get
much.
A new one. Yep, no problem.
We write little letters between a parent and a child. So, can we get something to write a letter of camp or letter home from camp for? You know,
bananas.
Bit by a turtle.
They like
to air back.
Learning to swim.
Got scared
about
the
day.
Natural water slide in the mud. We are learning how to swim.
Dear Mom, today we've tried to learn how to swim. It did not go well. I need a new pair of clothes. Love, Clementine. Dear Clementine, I'm sure you packed more than one pair of clothes. You should try on that dress. Maybe it will be better for swimming. Love, Mom. Dear Mom, on my other clothes are wet too. Besides, I did not think you wanted your wedding dress to get wet. Please send new clothes ASAP. Love, Clementine. Dear Clementine, here is my husband's wedding suit. Maybe that will be better. Don't get my dress wet. Love, Mom. Dear Mom, too late. It's already wet. Thank you for Dad's wedding suit. I will use it as a bathing suit. Love, Clementine. Dear Clementine, you can't just go swimming in my wedding dress. Maybe dry your clothes by a campfire. Love, Mom. Dear Mom, your wedding dress caught on fire. It burned the cabin down. What are we going to do now? Love, Clementine. Dear Clementine, stay calm. Use your wet clothes to battle the fire. Afterwards, you can buy some of your own clothes so you don't have to use mine. Love, Mom.
Our next game is going to be a singing rhyming game called Do Run Run. And if you repeat a rhyme or you use a slant rhyme, so something that doesn't actually rhyme, or you can't think of anything, you are eliminated and it will go until there's just one of us left. So could I please have a one syllable name? Fred.
Grace.
Met him on a Tuesday and his name was Fred. A do run, 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 a do run, run.
Fred didn't really like to go to bed.
A do run, 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 a do run, run, da da da, yeah.
He was also very dead.
Da da da, yeah.
His favorite color was red.
Da da da, yeah.
He enjoyed making bread.
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
In the winter, he would sled.
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
All of his pets he did fed.
Run, 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 da da da, yeah.
And his pencils were lead.
Da da da, yeah.
When he walked, he would tread.
Da da da, yeah.
And other things instead.
Run, 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 run.
He had all of the street cred.
Run, 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 run.
Right on his neck was a head.
Did you run, 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 did you run, run, da da da, yeah.
He had a lot of street cred,
da da da, yeah. Oh, 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 oh.
All right, can we get another one-syllable name?
Joe.
Ben.
I heard Ben. Met him on a Friday and his name was Ben.
A do run,
have a new one-syllable name. I heard Jim. Met him on a Wednesday, and his name was Jim.
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
He wasn't fat, he was very slim.
A do run, 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 a do run, run, da da da, yeah.
He got a trim.
Da da da, yeah.
Missed it on a whim.
Da da da, yeah.
His best friend's name was Tim.
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
He made a shot, he hit the brim.
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
But he never hit the rim.
His fortune's grim.
Da da da, yeah.
He had a friend named Mim.
Da da da, yeah.
And he went out on a whim.
May I please have another one syllable name? I'll take Mel. Mel. Met him on a Tuesday and his name was Mel.
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
He slipped, he fell.
A do run, 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 a do run, run, da da da, yeah.
He was doing real swell.
Da da da, yeah.
And also really well.
Da da da, yeah.
You could look at him and tell.
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
In his hair he would put gel.
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
I got nothing.
Oh, out of here!
Could we have a final one-syllable name? We are going to take
Joe.
Met him on a Thursday and his name was Joe.
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
He wasn't fast, he sure was slow.
A do run, 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 a do run, run, da da da, yeah.
He had a great flow.
Da da da, yeah.
It went really low.
Da da da, yeah.
And everyone said, whoa!
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
He had plants, he sure did grow.
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
When he went in a boat, he would row.
A do run, 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 a do run, run, da da da, yeah.
Balls he would throw.
Da da da, yeah.
The places he would go.
Da da da, yeah.
Oh, you know.
All his stuff in a bag he'd stow.
A do run, 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 a do run, run.
He had a bird, it was a crow.
A do run, 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 a do run, run, da da da, yeah.
He had a truck that would tow.
Da da da, yeah.
And something with...
But I forgot what the play's called, so if you could give me an adjective and a noun.
Slimy.
Ceiling tiles.
Small.
Banana.
Red lizard.
White.
Small.
Stocky.
We'll do quiet, and then we need a noun.
Banana.
Orange. Accordion.
Please, banana.
We'll do quiet, banana.
Yes.
Hey everyone, thank you for coming here. I'm really excited to see how you guys all work together and to see how the cast comes together. So first off, I really just like, this is a very intense drama, remember? So I would really like, I want you to play the stoic teacher, okay? And if you two could be the students, and if we could just start at the first scene, page 3. Let's go page 3 and start with get out your math homework, guys, okay?
Get out your math homework, guys. It's time to check the answers. Oh no, your answer to question number 3 is incorrect.
What? But I worked for the whole last night on this.
But -3 isn't possible seeing as we haven't learned negative numbers yet.
Teacher, I don't know why we'll ever use this in our lives.
I cannot believe you brought this up because just yesterday, I was standing in the checkout line and the person in front of me said, you can go in front of me if you can solve for this derivative. And I said, yes, I can. And I did it on the spot and leaped ahead in front of the person and got my groceries.
And see, that was perfect. I love the teacher. I think you really embodied her well. If we can just skip to later when the quiet banana enters at lunchtime. Let's just have you three, you're all the friends eating lunch, and obviously quiet banana comes in. So if we could have, but I think it should be like more emotional and just way bigger. So if you could be angry and you could be ecstatic and you could be just silly. And start with you'll be playing you're obviously silly guy one. I would like you to start with the line, what's that banana doing here?
Okay,
go.
What's that banana doing here? It's awful quiet.
I brought it for lunch! It's the first banana I've had all year! I'm so excited!
Okay.
I think it sucks! You like the banana more than me!
Well, who wouldn't love a banana more than you? It's quiet!
I can be quiet, too!
Uh-huh.
Well, just to add some little difference over here, okay? I feel kind of indifferent about this banana. I'm not like other guys.
Of course you're not.
I'd like to keep this scene going. I'd really like you to more highlight just the individuality, just the uniqueness of your character, okay? Just how different he is. Okay, come.
You stole that shirt from the lost and found, didn't you?
I may or may not have been a theft.
That's wrong.
Well, I'm just a little goofy, perhaps, okay? I just take things.
Wanna know what? Uh-huh. I took this banana from the lost and found too.
Well, okay, I'm gonna have to up my game a little bit here because I'm used to being not like you guys, okay?
Oh, of course. Well,
and scene. Okay, that was good. Let's skip just to the very end. Let's go to the last scene after he has, like, up the stakes and stolen the whole school to be different. Let's just go to the end where they finally get along with the teacher again, and they're like, "We math is good, you know, all that stuff. It all resolves." Let's just have that final ending scene once again, and,
You know, I know we had our differences, but I have a quiet banana.
A quiet banana?
Not just a regular banana. A quiet banana.
For your little old math teacher, mm-hmm. You shouldn't have.
And see, that was amazing. That was awesome. I'll get back to you on Thursday. Don't be posted.
Game show. I'm your host, Zoe McNally, and today we have Mr. Know-It-All with us. Mrs. Know-It-All, my mistake. Mrs. Know-It-All. She knows everything and anything, so if we can get a question from the audience to ask Mrs. Know-It-All.
Why?
How come?
Maybe a more specific question. She knows everything and everything.
What's the diet like? How many bubblegum balls fit in a gallon jug?
How many bubblegum balls fit in a gallon jug?
I
don't
think
that
there
are
25
bubblegum
balls
in
this world.
I guess it's unsolvable. Can we get another question from Mr. Know-It-All?
Why do you drive in a parkway and park in a driveway?
Why do you park in a driveway? Miss Know-It-All.
Parkway.
Are for people
who
need
to
park
once
in
a
car or not?
I don't know what you're parking there, but it should probably be a car. Anyways, can we get another question for Miss Nodal?
Why are you bacon?
How many planets bacon?
What are the monsters that live under your bed?
What are the monsters that live under your bed? Snowdog.
Monsters
are merely
fictional.
And the
realistic
version is
way
loans.
No. Well, I don't know monsters or loans at all, but there you have it. Alright, one more question for Miss Snowdog.
What do you think for ours at Ocean for men's?
Where's the milk my dad left for?
Why is the sky blue?
Why is the sky blue,
Miss Snowdog?
The
sky
is blue
because
it cried
very hard.
Maybe it's because all the pollution we're putting in the air. See you better, people. All right, one last question for Ms. Nodal.
Where is
that?
Is that
how does Bluetooth work?
How does Bluetooth
work? All right, for the extras, how to succeed in school?
School is for people who are
very
like losers.
Right. Only do good school if you're a loser, and that's all we have for tonight. Thank you. It's getting real hot in here, so you all can like run to the restroom, grab some water, etc., etc. But we have one more game to play for you guys, and it is called Waiter. It is our infamous pun game. We gathered some suggestions from the audience before the show started, and we are going to be doing some silly little puns based on what Wendy provides.
All right, first one. Waiter, there's an aquarium in my soup.
There's a aquarium in my soup. Oh wow, that's pretty fishy. Waitress, there is an aquarium in my soup.
Oh, the third mistake this week. We sure are in deep. Waitress, there's an aquarium in my soup.
Oh, those must be ocean fish, because you seem pretty salty about it. Waitress, yeah, there's an aquarium in my soup.
Oh dear, it does look pretty watery. Waiter, there's an aquarium in my soup.
Oh, yeah, that's gotta be a mistake if you bask me. Waitress, there's a aquarium in my soup.
Now, seahorse, sir. It says right on the menu that there's fish in this one.
Waitress, there's an aquarium in my soup. Oh, you know, it's actually the cephalopod special. Tonight, the cook is a sucker for that one. Waitress! Come here. Aquarium, soup, why?
I can see.
An entire house is in there.
Yes, waiter. There happens to be a house in my soup.
Oh, it's so tiny. I think that's adorable. Waitress. There's a house in my soup.
Yeah, the staff's been really off today. Last time we had this big company party, we really raised the roof. Waitress. Yeah, there appears to be an entire house in my soup.
I'm so sorry about that. We'll have this chef clear. I'm sure he has room to make a new one. Waitress, there's an entire house in my soup.
It must be the key ingredient today.
There was a house in my soup.
Well, I'm floored.
Waiter, there's a house in my soup.
Well, I'll address that with some soup.
There's now a zoo. There's all of a zoo in there.
Waitress.
There's a zoo in your soup. You ain't lying. Waitress. There's a zoo in my soup.
Oh, that new chef is a keeper. Oh! Waitress, there's a zoo in my soup.
Yeah, the chef's been monkeying around with new recipes. Waitress, there is a zoo in my soup.
That's just unbearable, isn't it? Waiter, there's a zoo in my soup.
Oh man, that chef's been putting so much new stuff in there. He's a bit of a cheetah. Waitress, there's a zoo in my soup.
Yeah, the new chef, he's kind of crazy. I think that we gotta cage him up. Waiter. Zoo.
Well, yeah. I'll hop to the kitchen and get you a new one.
Yeah, you will.
Thank you for addressing the elephant in the room.
Hi everyone watching in the live stream, it's me.
Yes.
Yeah. I've crunched the numbers multiple times. We are going to have more trash.
Can't we just tell the trash factories to, like, cut down on production?
I'm not in charge of that. I'm not trash factory guy. I'm mayor. So
dang it. Meanwhile, at the trash bag factory, so I took this needle, right? So when all the trash is there, we just poke it, and they pick it up, and it's just liquid.
And then
they don't know where it comes
that's
from.
So funny.
I know.
I think it's so silly.
That I covered in trash liquid.
Just a little. Pranksters we are doing.
Meanwhile, inside of a recently thrown out trash bag.
Us rats have it bad. We got it bad for sure.
We're poking all these holes in the trash
poking
bags.
Poking all these holes.
My house to eat.
Exactly. Getting rid of our swimming pools in here. It's just getting so heated without all the trash juice in here. I don't know how I'm going to hang out.
Cool down, man.
Just get it. We gotta find some sort of new place to hang out.
Yeah, definitely.
Exactly. Just
meanwhile, in the dumpsters behind school, dude.
Dumpster diving was the best idea we've ever had.
It was
such
a
good
idea.
I
can't
find my notebook.
You'll find it someday.
So who's the first to dive in?
Me.
Yeah.
Oh, it's nice.
My turn.
Watch out.
We got some trash liquid in here, guys. It's nice and warm.
Oh, that sounds awesome.
That's not
that
too.
Is so delicious.
This is like a free hot tub.
That's record for it.
Dude, who threw out an entire laptop?
We're gonna get rich.
Okay, meanwhile, at
the Trash Bag Production Company.
We gotta change something in our method here. I've heard kids, they're going in them like little hot tubs. We can't have that. That's just that.
I know, there's just no sanitation.
Yeah, so here's what I'm thinking.
All right.
Trash bag. You know, guys, one's inside the other.
You know, guys, I don't think it's that bad that the kids are coming in.
Yeah, you wouldn't be one of them.
No, I wouldn't be one of those kids.
You're awfully short.
No,
you have a mustache.
No, I'm not that short. This is a very real, authentic mustache. And I think that the trash pool.
Meanwhile, back at dumpster diving. Hey, guys, I think we should not do this, actually.
Why?
We shouldn't do this. Because.
Why? It's warm, and we got lots of new friends.
You're looking awfully suspicious.
You kind of
like administration.
No, I don't.
Wait,
this is crazy, guys.
He has a clipboard.
I'm just...
Faith will be giving me stage directions in the middle of the scene to throw us off, and Laurel will be giving Daisy stage directions. So can we have an occupational relationship?
Park
ranger and
Pokemon
and Pokemon.
We will be surgeons.
Surgeons.
Okay, so you make the incision right there.
Just do it?
Yeah, just do it. I won't look.
I won't look. Just do it.
Freeze!
Joyfully through her tears.
You're up so fast. I think I did it right.
Oh, it's so proud of you. Okay, so that's wrong, but that's okay. I'm proud of you still.
It's a good thing this is a practice doll.
Freeze!
In a low voice.
A.
What do you say?
You and me.
Freeze! She stretches and slowly goes into another room.
I don't know what she's talking about, man.
Freeze! She takes her by the hand. Since my training's over, I was thinking we could start a new company. Together.
Surgeons Incorporated.
That's a great name.
I like it. I was a little scared with your tone of voice and your whole image, but I get where you're going. So
you don't like the
mom? It's scary.
She wipes her sweaty hands.
It was scary. I was scared. But I think we're good now. I think Surgeons Incorporated is a good idea.
There's nothing to be scared of, okay? I've been going to surgery school for 3 weeks now.
Me too.
Yeah.
Better than this. I'm glad we went to surgery school the same amount of time, so I think we're about ready.
We're ready to start our own company.
Freeze!
She goes down and sits by her resting father.
So, my dad here.
Yeah.
He'd like to get in on this venture with us.
Is he the next patient?
No, he's just asleep right now.
Okay, glad to know he's fine.
Yeah, but I'm sure he'd be willing to lend us some money to start up the business.
That's perfect, because, like, money?
Yeah.
I don't have any.
Yeah, me either.
Freeze! She sinks slowly on the ground in shame.
It's okay. I don't have any money either. The 3 weeks in surgery school,
they cost everything!
Freeze!
She plays on the guitar and sings.
It's really hard to not have money.
So hard!
So hard to not have money. That's a song I wrote for you just now.
You wrote that for me?
For you.
Can that be the jingle of Surgeons Incorporated?
It plays 24/7, no ad breaks?
Yeah!
Yes!
Gentlemen, before I introduce this next game, I would just like to know, how are you enjoying your evening so far? Yeah. All right. This next game is called Emotional Room, and we will say goodbye to our four lovely improvers here, and we will call them back in just a moment. But first, I need something from you. All right. They are going to have 4 separate emotions. Each one of them will be assigned an emotion. They will slowly start to build the scene one by one. And the first person here, let's say their emotion is happy. They will start doing the scene as happily as can be. Then the next person walks in. Oh, they have a sad emotion. So they join in, and now the entire scene is sad, and so on and so forth. So, to begin with, can I please get a positive emotion? I like cheery. Can I get more of a like neutral type emotion? I like tired. And then can I get a like more like sad type emotion? I'll go with melancholy. And then can I have a very like, I guess like energetic type emotion? I like terrified. Go with that. All right, now on the count of 3, we are going to bring in our lovely improvers with a Hey You Improvers. 1, 2, 3! Hey You Improvers!
All right, well, they are getting their emotions. Could I please have a location?
A pool hall. Banana store.
We are in a secretary's office. So it's my first day, and I got all these new pencils that we can put in the little pencil holder right here. So then when the kids come and they need to fill out their forms, they can take one of mine. It'll be great. And then over here, we got like the 3 different types of tissues because kids are particular, right? And you gotta be prepared when you're a secretary. But I'm so ready for my first kid to come in and like need something, or a parent. It could be a parent too. It'll be so amazing, I'm sure.
Can I use these tissues as blankets?
Oh, sure, do whatever you want.
Yeah, thanks. That actually, it means a lot to me. I'll just, you know, I can sleep standing up.
Yeah, you know.
It's pretty crazy, right?
It's a good life skill.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, you want a cup of joe?
Oh, man. Yeah, I don't think this will wake me up.
I mean, it could hurt, right?
You know, it could never hurt. Never
placebo
could.
Placebo effect and all that jazz.
Placebo effect. You know, caffeine is an illusion, I'm convinced.
Hey, guys. Hi.
Hey. You in detention, too?
Secretary, yeah.
Yeah, I'm in charge, but yeah.
Yeah, I mean.
As a fellow detainee.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, she's been here a lot, so I guess she's always in detention.
No. Okay.
Yeah.
Cup of joe?
No, but I'll have one of those tissues.
Yeah.
All right. Guys, there's a new secretary today, and I'm so scared because I love the old one, but she's gone. Yeah. I'm so scared that you're not going to like me because I'm the new secretary,
what?
And I'm trying my hardest.
It's okay to not just say that in front of her.
You gave me a cup of joe.
I'm
trying your hardest. I guess that's okay, but just, it's not the same.
I know, and real kids are a lot scarier than like the ones I've been imagining in my head. I mean, I'm feeling a lot of negative energy from this side of the room.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I know, it's a lot. It's a lot to take in. I'm just gonna take a tissue. I'm gonna take a tissue.
I mean, she did all this work. She set it up, so I mean, she's doing her best. I don't want. Now I'm so scared they're gonna replace you too. You can't love anyone anymore.
Pencils or something.
I can try and use a pencil as a
blanket.
A blanket.
This isn't as good. It's kind of more going like bed frame.
Man, we could like. Sorry, I'm gonna find something else. I'm gonna,
I know I shouldn't leave detention like this.
I think that went really well.
Suggestions for an activity. How about this? In the front row, we'll get suggestions, and we are the activity. We are doing something specific.
Rowing a boat.
I heard rowing a boat. And one more activity.
Bowling.
I'll take bowling. Okay, so for our first activity, instead of rowing a boat, what are we rowing?
A car.
Boat.
I heard car. I'll take car. And instead of rowing the car in water, where are we rowing it?
Lava. Lava.
I'll take lava, I heard. And for our second one, we are bowling. But instead of bowling with a bowling ball, what are we using? I heard a carrot, so I'll be taking carrot. And instead of bowling pins, what is the carrot hitting?
Administrators.
How about we take a suggestion from this area? I'll take monkeys. On a count of three, can we call back Zoe? One, two, three.
Hey, Zoe!
No, no. This. Okay, order.
wound and we got off.
Is it serious? Is it what? It's a wound there, and it's a brotish, and then the achum, and then we go,
ooh!
Yes?
The most scared. Check it out.
Yeah. Ooh. Chill out. And it's sort of serious.
Alright, sorry, what are you doing?
We were boy.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah. With bamboo.
Of nursery rhyme news. Sadly, I have forgotten what our nursery rhyme is, so please, could you give me what it is?
Put the pig in the sack!
Little Miss Muffet!
Oh, I heard Little Miss Muffet! Now, I have with me my lovely associate, Miss Muffetress. Now, Miss Muffetress, I don't know much about this situation personally, so could you please give me a little bit of I guess the basic information.
Yes, well, you see, it's very tragic indeed. You see, many, many muffins are horribly mangled with such behavior that it was demonstrated in today's actions. And it's horrible. My heart goes out to the victims of this situation. I hope they receive closure.
Now, I do believe our lovely field reporter, Janice, is out there just searching the wide world for answers on this case. Janice, what do you have for us?
Hello! Thank you, George. Now I'm here with Little Miss Muffet herself. I heard this was a very traumatic incident. How are you feeling?
Well, that's a lot of questions. So definitely I'm feeling things. Yeah, it was just really scary and just like it was a bad experience. I don't even like whey. I don't even like curds. And it's gross. And it was just such an embarrassing time to like be eating that because now everyone knows I was eating curds and whey and that's just really gross things. I guess it was really scary and I hated it overall, but yeah.
You're not one of those people with arachnophobia, are you?
I hate spiders, yes. It was pretty awful.
Yes, back to you, Bob.
Thank you. Indeed, Bob George is my name. Now, Miss Muffetress, what you the mention of arachnophobia that is very interesting to me in this case because what I've heard on this case at least is that the spider was attempting to help Miss Muffet. Now, what's your stance on this? I suppose
you see, arachnophobia is actually completely a myth. Anyone who tells you that they are afraid of spiders actually are actively against spiders, all right? You see, spiders are among us. Recent studies have shown that one in every three working people is actually a spider. Yes. So witnessing this story today, it's, like I said before, devastating. See, to see these working amphibians, working spiders.
Both
amphibians
and erect.
Yes.
That's absolutely insane. Now I believe Janice is here with another interviewer here. Janice?
Yes, I'm actually here with the cousin of the spider. How are you feeling about this?
Well, I feel like our species as a whole, we've really taken a hit with this story. I mean, arachnophobia, as mentioned earlier, it's not real.
And it's a really big problem. And there's a really big stigma around spiders like us. And yeah, just getting rid of that. We're not the same as amphibians. A lot of people think that too.
There's so much stigma and
so much bad stuff about spiders, and we're really not that bad. So, yeah, I'm kind of mad.
I hear you. Back to you, Bob George.
Thank you so much, Janice. Now, tell me, Miss Muppetress, I'm still hooked on this whole arachnophobia, amphibiophobia war. This may be slightly off topic, but I believe there could be some way, shape, or form. It is still, I suppose, it is still integrated with this story. Would you please give me more information on this topic?
I would just like to firstly say how sorry, truly sorry I am, for even associating the two together. It was a blindsided moment of my own. And with my 15 years at the colleges, every college, 15 years. Now, back to the topic at hand. It is quite an ongoing war that's happening for many centuries. See, people actually think that the first American war was the Revolutionary War. That is false. All right, approximately 300 years before that was the amphibian and dreaded spider wars. Yes. It's still ongoing. There are frequent territory disputes. The most is probably the swamp.
Of the two. Yes.
The swamp. It's tragic to go there and see the wreckage left behind.
Indeed. What terrible times we live in. Now, Janice, I do believe that you have one last interviewee for us. Now, please, if you could, give us the scoop of what's happening over there.
I'm actually here with an amphibian. How are you feeling about all this?
I think that Miss Muppetess, I think her claims are very, I think she's made a lot of claims tonight, and I don't agree. And I would personally like to say I think I don't like her. So now that that's over with, I think the war was really scary, and I don't like Miss Muffetess, but I'm not really sure how I relate to the main story of Miss Muffet.
So are you in fact a spider?
No, I'm a frog.
Back to you, George Bob.
Thank you. Thank you. Wow. What a truly fascinating story. Truly, truly terrible what happened to Miss Muppet. But now, Miss Muppetress, if you have any final closing remarks you'd like to give.
I would just like to make a comment to that frog and say that they did not spend 15 years at every college.
Yes.
Learning.
Every single
apology
college.
Not accepted.
Aren't they supposed to be muted?
I think
they're
so.
They're supposed to be muted.
That's fine. Well, thank you all so much for tuning into this tonight's episode. Thank you so much, and back to your regularly scheduled programming.
Okay, guys, we have an escape for you. It is called Forward Reverse. So, basically what's going to be happening is we're going to be doing a scene, and at any point our coach on the side might call reverse, and then we have to do the same scene but backwards. So we're not speaking backwards, but we're going to be doing the lines in the opposite order. And she might call forward, we'll have to go forward again and then continue on with the scene. So to start us off, could I please have a task that we are accomplishing? We are mopping the floor.
So, I'm told that to get it all out, you gotta come in with the elbow grease, right? Like, right down in there.
Reverse!
So, I'm told to get it right, you have to come in with the elbow grease, like, right down in there.
Forward.
So I'm told to get it right, you gotta come in with the elbow grease right down in there. It doesn't smell shiny enough yet.
Reverse.
It doesn't smell shiny enough yet. Well, I'm told to get it right, you gotta get right in there with the elbow grease. Well, I'm told to get it right, you gotta go in with the elbow grease right in there. It doesn't smell shiny enough yet! Well, we've only done step one. I've got a whole booklet of more instructions yet.
Reverse!
Well, we've only done step one. I've got a whole booklet of instructions yet. It doesn't smell shiny enough yet!
Forever.
It doesn't smell shiny enough yet!
Well,
that's only step one. I've got a whole booklet of instructions yet.
Oh,
good. Good, we gotta follow every single step in the jog.
You betcha.
Good. Good, we gotta follow every singular step in the jog. That's only step one. I've got this huge booklet of instructions left yet. It doesn't smell shiny enough yet. It doesn't smell shiny enough yet. Well, that's just step one. I got this whole booklet of instructions yet.
Oh, that's good. We gotta follow every singular step of my job.
You...
Every singular step of my job has not been followed.
Reverse.
Every singular step of my job has not been followed. Every single step of my job has not been followed. Every single step of the jubab has not been followed.
Oh, good. We gotta follow every singular step of the jog. Oh, good. We gotta follow every singular step of the jog.
Every singular step of the jubab has not been followed.
Well, we just started. How could we have messed up already?
You had plenty of time. You had plenty of time.
Well, we just started. How could we have messed up already?
Every singular step of the jubab has not been followed.
Good. We gotta follow every singular step of the jog. That's just step one. I got this whole booklet of instructions yet. That's just step one. I got this whole booklet of instructions yet.
Good. We gotta follow every singular step of my job.
Every singular step of the job has not been followed.
We just started. How could we mess up already?
Oh, you had plenty of time.
It's because Charisse here was too busy smelling the floors. It's because Charisse here was too busy smelling the floors.
Well, you had plenty of time.
How could we have messed up already? It's just step one.
Every singular step of the job has not been followed.
Oh, good. We gotta follow every singular step of my job.
Well, that's just step one. I got this whole booklet of instructions to follow yet.
It doesn't smell shiny enough. I'm told to get it right, you gotta come in with the elbow grease and just get in there.
Hello, I'm Allie Trebek, and welcome back to Jeopardy. I got multiple suggestions from you during the break, but there is, in fact, more than I need. So from this front part of the audience, can I have a scientific fact that may or may not be true?
Elephants
have
five toes.
Spiders are amphibians.
And can I have a famous person? I heard Zendaya. Now, can I have a location from this half of the room?
Water or the ocean?
Las Vegas.
Home
Depot.
Area. I'll do Area 51. Now, can we call in our Jeopardy contestants with a Hey You Jeopardy contestants? 3, 2, 1.
Hey You Jeopardy contestants!
Oh.
And hello, everybody. Welcome to Jeopardy. I am your host, Allie Trebek, and let's meet our wonderful contestants, starting with our returning champion contestant number one.
Oi, the name's Johnny Rockbottom. I'm a little bit of a little celebrity around here, isn't it? Makes nice music.
And our next contestant.
My name is Tao Li Do. You can call me Tao. I run a Minecraft server and a Reddit. You should follow me. Join my server.
And our third contestant.
My name is Dan, but people call me Dan the Tan Man. Oh!
Write that down. Oh! I'll make a Reddit for you.
Okay, Johnny Rockbottom, as our returning champion, you get to pick the first category.
All right. Methinks I'll take this is a bit of a difficult situation here. I'll take classical rock musicians for about £500.
All right, this person is famous for saying the definition of fear is fear itself. Yes, Tao.
I'm thinking Try Hard Ninja, the guy who wrote Five Nights at Freddy's songs and the Minecraft songs.
That is correct. Now, would you like to choose our next category?
I'm thinking bullying my Minecraft staff members for 400.
These are often found in Florida.
Think.
Yes, Johnny.
John Lennon.
That is sadly incorrect.
And
yes, Dan.
It's me because of how tan I am. Oh!
That is correct. Oh! Now, would you like to choose our next category?
I would like trucks. Monster trucks and trucks for 500.
Spiders are this. Yes, Tao.
The most hostile mob in Minecraft.
That is correct and very true.
Thank you.
Would you like to choose our next category as we enter the double Jeopardy round where all points are doubled?
Ooh. I'm thinking r/neckbeards for 600.
Zendaya is famous for inventing this.
Ding.
Yes, Johnny.
The jazz guitar.
That is sadly incorrect. Yes.
She invented all of Reddit.
That is sadly also incorrect. Yes, Dan.
The state of Florida. Oh.
That is correct. Whoa! Oh. Would you like to choose our next contestant? Would you like to choose our next category?
Yeah, sure. I'll choose cars for 500.
A basement and Area 51 have this in common.
Yes.
Well, if you actually followed my Area 51 Reddit, you would know that a basement and Area 51 both have me in it.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Would you like to choose our next category?
I'm thinking r/cars, the Reddit board for 800.
Apples are secretly this.
Ding.
Yes. What? Now it's time for Final Jeopardy. Our Final Jeopardy category is celebrities that play Minecraft and also live in Florida. Contestants, please place your wagers. Okay, good. Now that you've placed your wagers, here is the Final Jeopardy answer. The sky does this. Okay, in third place is Dan the Tan Man. Would you like to give us your answer?
No, makes me tan.
Sadly, that is incorrect. What did you wager?
All my money.
Unfortunately, but fortunately, we will be having to take that off of you.
Oh.
And Tao, you were in second place. What was your answer?
What is the sky / toggle downfall is the command to make the sky rain in Minecraft.
Sadly, that is also incorrect. What did you wager?
Oh, my residency in my mom's basement.
Don't let her keep the basement.
Thanks.
And Johnny Rockbottom, what was your answer?
I said, what the sky does, what is, gives me new inspirations for music and other fantastic, a little bit indie projects.
That is correct.
winner! So what are you doing?
I wagered 17,000 British pounds.
Okay, that is it for Jeopardy. Until next time, I'm Alex Trebek. Good night.
Unfortunately, we do only have one more game left in the night. I know. But before that, we do have some thanks we want to give out to people.
Yes, so we want to especially thank the school tech people who got us set up with all this stuff to do the live stream. That was a lot of work earlier today, and we got it, guys!
Helping us get this room and everything set, and respond to me and Daisy's many, many emails that we've gotten.
And we would also like to thank our super amazing, excellent coach, Wendy. You guys. Life skills and improv skills, and is just always there for us. She's so awesome.
And lastly, of course, we need to thank all of you guys. Improv literally is impossible without an audience.
All right, so now we're going to be going into our last game, which is called Freeze. So, basically, two people will be doing a scene up here, and at any point, someone in the back line might call,
freeze!
And then they will come up, tap someone out of the scene, and assume their exact position, and then a new scene will begin. So, to start us off, could we have your favorite line from tonight?
Arachnids are amphibians.
Thank you for coming to my TED Talk, and my first point is that arachnids are amphibians. I know this might come as a shock to some of the spider experts in the room, but I have a graph.
Oh my gosh, look at that peak and valley!
The neighbor's dog.
I took a stick. Maybe we can scare it away.
I don't like him. He's very big and scary. He's like that.
Freeze! Okay. All right. So I got an actual plan, right?
What's your plan?
I'm gonna just take the school. Just gonna take it.
You're crazy.
You're crazy.
Insane.
Oh
you
my
would
god.
It, you wouldn't.
I would.
You wouldn't freeze.
I would.
Have you ever been to Florida? You get down there and just like, oh,
I love Florida! I'm so glad you brought that up because I love Florida!
Oh, the sun and the cars and the
And you see a nice truck and you're like, oh! I get that feeling a lot.
Yeah.
Florida's so nice, man. You get all tan and it's just like, oh,
check out my tan!
We've been in this trash dumpster for a long time. Do you think this rash is bad?
Well, it looks like other rashes, but usually rashes aren't good, so...
Freeze!
Clementine, sweetie, the wedding dress? Just all of it in the fire.
It was an accident!
You swear...
Who knows the fabric burns?
Freeze!
It's not clean enough.
Not shiny enough, right?
Not shiny enough.
Not shiny enough.
Not clean enough. It doesn't smell good enough. I want to see my reflection. Freeze!
Honey, I brought you some pizza rolls. Can you take a break, please, from gaming?
No.
Just 5 minutes.
Minecraft is forever. I'm managing a server right now. I'm yelling at my managers.
Freeze!
Okay, so we just.
Okay, we got it.
Okay,
dang it! I was close.
So how about the skyline thing? The zip line.
Yeah.
No.
I got this. If you can do our secret handshake.
Oh, okay.
Here, wait, we'll demonstrate. Ready?
Okay. I think I got it. So it's I don't know which one to do with you. I'll do with
you. Okay.
Freeze! I really don't understand your new yoga technique.
Oh, you need to trust the process.
It's a stretch, and they're like, whoa.
Every muscle is supposed to be burned. Freeze!
So now that we're at the top of the mountain, I'm starting to wonder if the granola replacing the like rope on the packing list was a good plan.
Freeze! The boat is leaking. You did not build it right.
Okay.
It works.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you.